In this video, we will discuss whether to use the full width at half maximum or the integral breadth to calculate the deduced parameters from XRD data like crystallite size and microstrain, etc. Let's first discuss the difference between the full width at half maximum and the integral breadth. If we consider a Gaussian distribution, then Y0 is the bottom and YC is the maximum of the curve. So, YC minus Y0 by 2 is halfway, which we call the full width at half maximum, in short, FWHM. In the Scherrer equation or the microstrain, we represent it by beta, which is measured in radians. In the older research, the FWHM value has been used as beta. However, in the modern analysis software, the integral breadth value has been used as beta, which is represented as L. Integral breadth is defined as the area of the curve divided by its height. Let's start with the XRD data in Origin to learn how to calculate FWHM and integral breadth and analyze their differences in calculating different parameters from XRD data. This is the XRD data and let me plot it as a line plot. Principally, an average value of the FWHM or integral breadth is to be calculated from all the peaks. But for the sake of the tutorial, I am taking the most intense peak, which is the first peak, and will do all the required calculations from it. To fit this peak, go to Analysis, Fitting, Nonlinear Curve Fit, and open dialog. In the category of Origin Basic Functions, select the Gaussian function. Click Few Iterations to see everything is good. And then Fit until Converge. The fitting data have been generated. Let's go to Nonlinear Fit 1. Here, under the Parameters tab, we have all the required data. Let's copy all the data to the Excel template. Here we calculate the integral breadth, which is the area divided by height of the peak. Now, we calculate the crystallite size using the Scherrer equation. In this equation, K and lambda are being multiplied. We will have to convert the beta values in radians, which are in degrees by default. We are having two theta values here, so I will have to divide it by 2 to get theta. As Excel by default calculates the trigonometric functions in radians, so we will take radian beforehand to finally get the value in degrees. The whole result is divided by 10 to get the value in nanometer, as we have lambda in angstrom. Now, let's calculate the crystallite size by utilizing the value of integral breadth instead of FWHM. And here we see that it comes out slightly less than the FWHM case, with a difference of 6%. This way, we also calculate the microstrain first with the FWHM and then with the integral breadth. And we see that 6% difference comes here as well. It is preferred to calculate the XRD parameters by utilizing the integral breadth than the FWHM. Thanks for watching the video.